American Top 40.
This is Casey Kasem in Hollywood on AT40, and now at number 10, I have a song that's the first chart hit by the artist whose voice has helped sell over 15 billion hamburgers. Not to mention a lot of fried chicken and plenty of cola. The man is Barry Manilow, primarily a record producer working with such artists as Bette Midler. But during the last few years, Barry's been making a little money on the side, writing and recording commercials for radio and television. He's made a dozen biggies, and they've become so well known that in his stage act, he features a medley of commercial jingles. And his audiences just join right in on such favorites as Have a Finger-Lickin' Good Time Barrel of Fun, or Join the Pepsi Generation, or You Deserve a Break Today. Don't mind saying, I'm impressed. His first pop hit moves into the top 10 this week. At number 10, here's Barry Manilow.
I remember all my life, raining down as cold as ice.
American Top 40.
This is Casey in Hollywood and AT40 counting them down. And at number 28 in our survey is the latest hit by one of Marie Osmond's birthday gifts. If you saw the recent TV special celebrating Marie's 18th birthday, then you saw this man pop out of a huge gift box, kiss Marie on the cheek, and present her with a baby beagle. This week, he's celebrating his 9th Top 40 hit. Here's Barry Manilow with Daybreak.
I'm singing to the world,
Well, now we're up to the hit song that commemorates an awkward reunion. This is the Barry Manilow story that I first told you a couple of months ago. Barry's parents were divorced when he was 2 years old, and his father abandoned the family soon after. Over the years, Barry managed to put his father out of mind and out of his life, until about a year ago. Here's what Barry told writer Chip Wharton. We were playing a concert in Westbury, Long Island. I was in my dressing room after the show, changing my clothes, when all of a sudden, this man walks right into the room, calmly walks in and says, I'm your father. I just stood there in my shorts and all I could say was, oh, hi. He told me he thought it was a good show and he wanted to see me again, and then left. Those are the words of 33-year-old Barry Manilow describing his first meeting with his father, whom he hadn't seen in 30 years. Barry said he chose this latest song to record because it pays tribute to that father and son reunion. Like it says in the song, love is easier when it's far away.
American Top 40.
Billboard ranks them, AT40 counts them down. There's a superstar in this week's countdown who recently had to cancel his tour of Europe because he caught pneumonia. The artist is Barry Manilow. And I wouldn't even be mentioning this if it weren't for the way he got pneumonia. It developed from a cold Barry caught by appearing on stage at a concert without any pants on. But that sounds worse than it was. Here's the story. The last concert of Barry's tour through the British Isles, before going on to the European continent, was in Edinburgh, Scotland. Well, he decided to have some fun that night and came out on stage wearing a traditional Scottish kilt. The short wool skirt that's been worn by burly Scotsmen for centuries. But it was cold that night in Edinburgh, and the winds were coming off the moors. And Barry caught a cold. He says, I didn't realize when you're wearing kilts how prone you are to a lethal draft. Well, that cold turned into pneumonia, and Barry had to call off his tour while he recuperated. The moral of that story is, when in Rome, do as the Romans do. But when in Scotland, keep your pants on. Barry Manilow's latest hit comes in at number 37 this week, the highest debuter in the countdown. It's a remake of the old Four Seasons hit, Let's Hang On. Here's Barry.
There ain't no good in our goodbye.
We're on our way to the number one song in the USA. Now on American Top 40, we're up to the latest hit by a Brooklyn-born superstar who just earned himself a place in the Guinness Book of World Records by setting a new record in Broadway theater history. His show took in more than $750,000 in a single day. And in setting that record, he beat out such monster Broadway hits as Grease, Fiddler on the Roof, Dreamgirls, and Cats. The superstar who set this record is Barry Manilow. For his recent 2-week engagement in New York City, Barry decided he wanted to do a concert series on Broadway. So his management rented the famous Eurus Theater, which is normally used for plays. They took out ads announcing Barry's concert in all the local papers. And the first day that tickets went on sale, Barry's fans anteed up an unbelievable $782,000, the most money ever collected in one day in Broadway theatrical history. And the Guinness Book of World Records editor, Norris McWhirter, says that that massive box office gross has earned Barry a place in the book's next edition. This week, Barry's latest hit continues to earn him points in our own AT40 Book of Records. With his 24th Top 40 hit out of 25 chart appearances, here's Barry Manilow at number 32 and Some Kind of Friend.
The hits from coast to coast.